In this class, we'll discuss about VSWR. VSWR will actually stand for voltage standing wave ratio. So it is nothing but, it is something called as voltage standing wave ratio, right? So it is some ratio. Now what is this ratio actually? This is nothing but VSWR is nothing but is a ratio of V max, which is nothing but the maximum voltage on the transmission line, to that of minimum voltage on the transmission line, which is also equal to 1 plus mod tau by 1 minus mod tau, where tau is nothing but your reflection coefficient, right? So it is nothing but the ratio. We know that on a transmission line, at some point it's a sinusoidal voltage will be moving, right? At some point you'll have V max and some point you'll have V min. So it is the ratio of that maximum to that of minimum voltage, which in terms of reflection coefficient comes out to be 1 plus tau by 1 minus mod tau. Now, if I want to understand what is the physical meaning of voltage standing wave ratio, how I can understand this? This is very easy. What I'm going to do is, let's say that I'm sending some wave from here through some pipe. So this is, let's say, some pipe. What I did is, the moment wave was supposed to reach here, I closed this one. Okay? So what will happen? The moment the wave was going and then it hits the wall, you know that it is closed, it is going to come back again, right? So the wave, same wave is again coming back, right? Again you close this side also. So what will happen is, this to and fro motion will be keep on happening, right? So at the same time the wave is going also, at the same time the wave is coming back also, right? So it looked like this wave is standing still, so it looked like there is nothing happening, but actually that wave is going also and the wave is coming back also. Now if it is not easy to understand, there is a practical example from which we can understand. If you have went to any seashore, what you can observe is, the ocean waves will be coming and it will be hitting the walls, right? So if I'm standing here, if I look, does it mean that only the waves which are coming towards me, right? So let's say that some person is standing here, okay, some person is standing here and the waves are coming. So to him, what it appears like, the wave is coming towards him, right? But if you see, if these waves will come, let's say there's a wall here, and the waves will hit the wall and again that waves will go back, right? So at the same time, though it is looking at, if you look like the wave is coming to you, at the same time the wave is also going back also, right? So the both the things are happening, right? So again, if you take an example of water, what will happen? The water will come, it will hit the wall, again it will go back, it will hit the wall, again it will. So this motion, you see, it is coming, hitting the wall, it is going back, again hitting the wall. So it will be like of a continuous, right? So this looks like as if the water itself is standing, right? So this is what is called as a standing wave. Okay, so we have understand what is a standing wave and what is a, how it is related to a physical world. Okay, now next thing is, what is this V max and V min, how it is related, right? So V max is nothing but the point on the transmission line. So if I have any transmission line like this, let's say that this is my transmission line, right? So this is ZL, this is Z naught, at any point on the transmission line where voltage is maximum. Okay, so when, if my voltage is maximum, can I say that at that point my impedance will be minimum? Agree, right? If you want the V max, then your impedance at that point should be minimum, right? And that minimum impedance, if you want to find it out at what length the minimum, or I can say the minimum impedance will happen, is nothing but it's given by 1 by 2 beta. So what we are trying to find it out, at what length the minimum impedance will occur. If the minimum impedance will occur, it means at that point your maximum voltage maximum will occur, right? So this will be nothing but 5 plus 2m plus 1 pi, right? And where m is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, correct? So again, the interesting thing to note is, though I am saying this is, if you substitute at this length, your your minimum impedance will occur, which ultimately saying that your voltage maxima will occur, right? So what you can find it out, you can easily find it out at what length on the transmission line your voltage maxima will exist, right? In the same way, my Z min, or I can say that my Z min or Z max, sorry, the Z max, if the impedance is maximum, then your voltage would be minimum. So this is nothing but this correspond to actually your V max, and this correspond to your V min. So this just a correspond, okay? So Z max is nothing but, what will be Z max? Minus 1 by 2 beta, okay? So it would be phi plus 2 m pi. Again, m is 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is nothing but the length. If you want to calculate it out at what position your impedance will be maximum. If your impedance is maximum, then your voltage will be minimum at that point, right? So you can calculate. So basically, if you want to calculate the maxima, at what length the maxima will exist and what length your minima will exist, this is how you will find it out. Another thing is, if I want to find it out the relation between the V max, if the V max exists, it means the I max will also exist. If V min exists, it means I min and I max will also exist, right? So if I want to find it out the relation between V max and V min, or I max and I min, what is the relation? Let's see that. So we are done here. Let's see that, how I can do that. So what we are saying is, basically, we want to conclude the relation between V and I, right? So what we're going to do is, I'm going to draw this. So this is what is your V max, and this is your length. So this is the length towards, if you're moving towards G generator, this is what is your V min. Then your I will be looking like this. So the point where your V max will exist, at that point you will have I min, and the point where your V min will exist, at that point you will have I max. This is the relation between your V max and, or basically it's a relation between a voltage and current in transmission line, okay? So wherever the point, you can see that at this point, if this length, if I consider this length, at this length, if I go, I'll find the voltage as maximum, but at that length, your current will be minimum. If I go here at some length, I'll find that the voltage is minimum, but your current would be maximum. It means your current and voltage will be phase shifted by 180 degree, right? So in the transmission line, your maximum voltages are nothing but this will be phase shifted by 180 degree. Okay, what else I can do is, if I want to find it out Z max, which we already did that, what is the length, at what length your Z max will happen? It would be nothing but, can I say that it's an impedance, right? So it would be a ratio of V max divided by I min, agree, right? It is nothing but the ratio of maximum voltage by minimum current, so your impedance will be maximum. Right? If I want to find it out Z min, the value, it would be nothing but V min divided by I max, right? This is how it is, right? So this would be nothing but, if you want to find it out, this will be nothing but your Z naught S, and this would be nothing but Z naught by S. Where S is nothing but your standing wave ratio. This sometime it is being represented as S. So your Z max is equal to Z naught S, and your Z mean in a transmission line is equal to the Z naught by S. Right? We'll see how to solve a numerical on this in the next videos.